So, you want to make your own game?
Yes. Yes, I do.
But where do you even start? Which game engine to use? Do you need to know programming? What about art and animation? It's overwhelming, right?
Yes, it is.
I get it. I've been there too. Hi, I'm Aman and I've been on this game dev journey for over a year now. I recently published a board game on the Play Store and trust me, I had all the same questions when I started. In this video, I'm going to break it all down and lay out a clear step-by-step roadmap so you can start making games today even if you have zero experience. Alright, let's start with one of the first big decisions you will make, picking a game engine. Now, there are hundreds of game engines out there and every developer praises the engine that they use. But for beginners, focusing on a popular ones is a smart move, cause they have large communities, plenty of learning resources and strong support, making it easier to find tutorials, troubleshoot bugs and get help when needed. The three big names are Unity, Unreal Engine and Godot. When I was just getting started, I couldn't decide which engine to commit to. My advice? Give each of them a try. Watch a couple of tutorials and make a very simple project in each. That way, you will get a feel for how they work and which one vibes with you. It's like tasting different flavors of ice cream until you find the one you can't get enough of. Unreal is famous for its stunning graphic and 3D games. It's the go-to engine for AAA games and its node-based system called Blueprints lets you build logic visually if you are not ready to dive deep into coding. That said, Unreal also uses C++ for more advanced work. If you choose Unreal, you won't be coding a lot cause most of the tutorials use Blueprint to make games. But there's a problem. Since you are just starting out and if your PC isn't top of the line, Unreal might feel a bit heavy. It demands strong hardware and can have a long startup times. Some projects take 30 plus minutes to open as they grow.
That's a lot.
Unity is very popular, especially among indie developers. It uses C# for scripting and also offers visual scripting tools similar to Unreal's Blueprints. There are tons of tutorials available, but mostly all of them use C# while making games. So if you choose Unity, you will be forced into coding from the start, quite the opposite of Unreal. Unity's free version is great until your game starts earning money. Then you might need to upgrade to Pro version, which kicks in if your game earns more than $200,000, where Unreal charges 5% of the revenue if your game earns more than $1 million. Anyway, I don't think pricing matters here a lot, because these engines only charge if you earn a lot. Then obviously you can give some piece of the pie to the game engine too. Godot is fantastic that came into spotlight after the Unity runtime controversy. It is open source engine that's completely free to use. It primarily uses GDScript, a language that's easy to pick up. It's a lot like Python and it also supports C#. With Godot, you get to dive right into game development without worrying about licensing fees or revenue cuts. But Godot doesn't offer a built-in visual scripting tool like Unreal or Unity. So, if you're not ready to write code, it might feel a bit more intimidating at first. I started with Unreal because I was attached to its visual flair, but my computer couldn't handle it very well. I eventually switched to Godot and it made a world of difference. Now I use Godot for most of my 2D projects, though I still dabble in Unreal for 3D stuff. If you're confused, it might be best to experiment with all three. Make a tiny project in each engine and see which one feels right. Remember, this is your creative playground. There's no one-size-fits-all solution here, so trust your instincts. Once you have picked an engine, the next step is to learn the basics. This is where you really start to understand how the engine works. First things first, decide if you want to dive into 2D or 3D game development. Your answer will influence which tutorials you look for and which engine features you will focus on. I think starting with 2D games can be easier and more beginner-friendly before moving on to 3D. But in the end, it's your choice. You can skip 2D and jump straight into 3D if you prefer. Then, head over to YouTube and search for tutorials that match your chosen style and game engine. I recommend starting with a simple project, something that guides you through the very basics. As you follow along, take your time to understand each step. In this phase, most people tend to just copy everything step by step, without even understanding most of the stuff. Just to finish the video quickly, don't do that. Take your time to understand what you are doing and why. If the video doesn't explain it, look it up on the internet. Give yourself up to 3 weeks to get comfortable with your engine. The goal here is to build a strong foundation without getting stuck in the tutorial loop forever. That's why the time limit is maximum of 3 weeks. After reaching the 3-week mark or feeling like you have learned enough, it's time to put your skill to the test by making some simple games. This phase is all about experimentation and learning by doing. But don't pressure yourself to create the next big hit. Begin with a very basic concept, something that you can build on step by step. For example, if you're interested in making an endless runner, first figure out how to make your character run. Start with a model and the basic movement controls. Once you figure it out, work on making the character run continuously. Next, create a system to generate obstacles or tiles dynamically as the game progresses. By breaking your game into small manageable chunks like this, you will not only learn new concepts along the way, but you will also avoid getting overwhelmed by trying to do everything at once. Experiment with different mechanics, play around with settings, and even break things on purpose to understand how they work. The more you iterate on your projects, the more confident you will become in your abilities. If you are stuck for ideas, take inspirations from other indie games on itch.io. Play a few games, note what you love about them, and think about how could you recreate or improve upon those ideas. Or you can take classic games like Flappy Bird and add your own twist to it. And one of the biggest challenges for new developers is feeling like they have to create all their own assets. Trust me, you don't have to. There are countless free assets available online that can jumpstart your project. Websites like itch.io offer free and paid 2D sprites, 3D models, sound effects, and even complete asset packs. Using these resources lets you focus on learning game development instead of getting stuck on art and design. That said, once you are comfortable with the basics of your game engine, it's worth learning some fundamentals of 2D or 3D art. For example, in 2D, Asprite is great for creating sprites, and Photoshop can be used to design and edit various assets and UI elements. In 3D, Blender is a popular tool for modeling. You don't need to become an expert, just understanding the basics will help you tweak existing assets or make small adjustments to fit your needs. If you are not interested in art and design, don't force yourself to spend hours creating highly detailed assets. Instead, learn just enough to make simple edits or customize free assets from sites like itch.io. I have seen too many people get stuck in the art phase, thinking, once I finish my assets, I will start game development. But that just slows you down. Focus on making your game first, using available resources, and don't let art become a roadblock. Don't stop at one project. The more simple games you make, the more you learn. Each project will teach you something different, and remember, every game you complete is a victory worth celebrating. One more thing that itch.io has is game jams. If you are feeling a bit adventurous and want to test your skills under a deadline, game jams are an excellent option. Game jams are events where you create a game in a limited time frame, usually with a theme. They are a great way to force yourself to work fast, learn new techniques quickly, and see how far you can push your creativity. And when you release your game at the end of the jam, you get real feedback from players. This can be incredibly valuable in learning what works and what doesn't. While you can join a game jam solo, I highly recommend teaming up. It can be nerve-wracking at first, especially if you're shy like I was, but you will soon realize that many fellow newbies are in the same boat. Join the event's Discord server, DM people, and either find or create a team. The biggest thing that kept me from participating in game jams at first was not having a team and being too shy to reach out. I felt like everyone else was more experienced and I wondered, how can I compete it? Why would anyone want me on their team? But that's not how it works. There are plenty of beginners in game jams too. You can start by teaming up with other newbies who are also looking to learn. Let me share a quick story. When I joined my first game jam, I was too shy to message anyone at first. But I finally gathered the courage to send a DM asking if there was a space in their team. I got a few no's, but after that, my shyness disappeared. I started messaging more people without overthinking, and eventually, I formed my own team of 4. Though, to be fair, 2 of them left halfway through and didn't contribute. But I still learned a lot from the experience. That's why I strongly suggest working in a team. You will learn teamwork, how to split roles efficiently, and how to collaborate on a project under a deadline. Itch.io hosts tons of game jams, so check them out and start participating. After going through all these steps, it's finally time to release a game. And no, it doesn't have to be the next big hit. Start with something simple. Add your own twists and set a deadline. Give yourself a maximum of 2 months to develop it. Then release it on Steam, the Play Store, or any other platform you prefer. This will give you hands-on experience with the entire game development cycle, from making a game to actually publishing it. You will learn how to set up a Steam page, create a trailer, and market your game. All valuable skills for any developer. And like I said earlier, if you are not experienced in asset creation like me, don't waste too much time making everything from scratch. There are tons of free assets available online. Just do a quick search or check out this GitHub page full of free and paid resources, including 2D assets, 3D models, audio files, and UI collection. Once you have gone through all these phases, you will be ready to build your own games with confidence. So, what are you waiting for? Close YouTube and start your amazing game dev journey. Best of luck.